New reports have revealed that the company that operated the vessel that struck the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore, well, they have a history of punishing whistleblowers who point out safety violations by the company. And this investigation continues. We're probably going to hear more and more stories about the company's gross misconduct. I've got Ring of Fire's Farron Cousins with me to talk about this. So, Farron, what struck me about the story, okay, I get that there should be no, you know, we represent whistleblowers. I mean, I understand that very, very well. I don't understand what the problem is if an employee says, look, you got problems with the boat, and he tells the employer that, and at the same time he tells the Coast Guard. Tell me about your take on this story. Yeah, I'm missing something.
Well, you know, we've got this law called the Seaman's Protection Act.
Right.
And what it says is that, hey, if you're working on the water, on a boat, whatever it is, you go to the Coast Guard when you have issues with the company rather than going to company management. So it is a bit weird. You have the federal government saying, hey, listen, if you see a problem, don't go to your boss. You come tell us. And it may have to, it's a confusing law. And again, like you said, I'm not sure it makes total sense.
It doesn't,
but if we're trying to rationalize it, it might be because of what's at stake. Obviously, when you're in a very large barge or vessel out there, a problem may immediately need a regulator to come in and fix it before the company
could. Right. Think about what you just said. We're saying go to the bureaucracy first.
Right.
You know, before you tell your employer. Yeah, I mean, the employer, I guess maybe this was done to protect the potential whistleblower, but the whistleblower has protection anyway. Whether they go to the employer and say, look, you got something on the barge that's going to kill people. And that's what happened here. Six people were dead.
Yeah.
And they had all kinds of problems on this barge. They got fire control problems. They had mechanical problems that were overwhelming. They had seaworthy problems that were overwhelming. So you go to the employer and say, you got these problems. At the same time, you go to the Coast Guard. But I'm just not following this when they're saying go to the bureaucrats first, right? Go to the Labor Department first. Especially if it's something as important and timely as this. It's kind of an exigent kind of problem, isn't it?
Yeah, and I mean, when you are talking about problems like this, obviously the person or group who's in an immediate position to be able to fix it would be the company itself. But with this particular whistleblower in question, it wasn't necessarily about that particular boat, but this whistleblower had told the company, he said, listen, you've got problems with the safety features, you've got problem with the boats themselves, you got people drinking on the job.
And they didn't do anything.
Right.
That's different.
Exactly.
Okay? That's the distinction in the story.
Yeah, and so that's what is weird about it, is you've got this law that almost conflicts with common sense.
It does. It totally conflicts. Because in the end, the employee is paid $700,000 in damages and back wages, which should be. I mean, look, we have handled horrible whistleblower cases where the employer just victimizes whistleblowers. But to say, wait, don't tell the employer, tell the bureaucracy first. That is just a non-starter. I just don't get that logic in this case.
It is really weird. It's almost like it doesn't even give the company the opportunity to fix problems, because problems happen, right?
Yeah.
Machinery does break down. Engines do fail.
Yeah.
And rather than immediately running to the Coast Guard, it should be, hey,
fix this.
Look, you know, we've got some bolts that are starting to come out here. Company, let's take care of this. It's what we do. It's part of regular maintenance. But
in this situation, he did that.
Yes, he did.
And he did it. The employer says, okay, we're going to take care of it. Nothing happened.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, you might expect that every time.
Yeah.
But you at least go to the people that have their finger on the pulse, that can stop that ship immediately and do something immediately about it. It's just a bad law. It's the way it's written. I think the whistleblower is going to be protected either way.
Yeah.
So I don't quite understand.
And
this.
And in this case, the employee did everything right. The company did everything wrong.
Well, that's right. That's right. But this falls on the Seaman's Protection Act, 1984 Act, and it almost screams out, "Go to the bureaucrats first," which is what it's saying. Go to the bureaucrats first. You don't even have to tell the employer. But the employer is controlling that boat.
Yeah.
It makes no sense.
Ring of Fire founder and host of America's Lawyer, Mike Papantonio, has a new book, came out this week, called Suspicious Activity. Like his other books before it, this book actually deals with real legal cases that Mike Papantonio has handled, but in a fictionalized way. The book follows the character of Nick Dicotomis that Papantonio first introduced in his book Law and Disorder, and it carries on the story that began in Law and Disorder through Law and Vengeance, Law and Addiction, Inhuman Trafficking, and now Suspicious Activity. This book in particular deals with the financial institutions that have helped launder money for terrorist organizations, which of course is a topic we have covered extensively here on Ring of Fire. So, if you're a follower of Mike Papantonio's books, or if this is your first one, you can get your copy of Suspicious Activity now. Just go to mikepapantonio.com and place your order. And if you haven't already, check out Mike's other books, also available on mikepapantonio.com.